Hello, what's popping? I am the Kenyan beast. Of course, we are doing it the African way. Thank you so much for subscribing to my YouTube channel. All those new subscribers, thank you so much for passing by. You should stay here. You have to stay here. For my returning subscriber, I'm humbled, man. Thank you so much for supporting me. Yeah. So, by the way, you have heard the situation of Kenya, Nairobi, or the Kenya at large. We are having, it's called El Nino, floods everywhere. It's bad out here. Like, people are being carried away, cars are being carried away, and that's our Kenya now. the drainage system is poor, everything is poor. The government doesn't have the maybe emergency evacuation of people, just like that. But regardless, we are doing good. So today, as I woke up in the morning, one of my friend, she is in the United States of America. I have she's Kenyan. She's a teacher in the United States of America. So we talk sometimes, how things are going on. And now today she called me and she told me that, yo, today I've come across something bad that I've never want to experience again, and I've never want anybody to experience again. So it's her first time to come across to come across a black hating on a black. You understand what I'm saying? She is a black, she's Kenyan, and she came across someone who is a black, and a black hating on a black in another man's country or in another country. And I said, yo, we need to talk about this, because we are having, or we mostly we have this thing that we face when you are from other country, when you are in a, in white country, like in the US of America, like a white man hating on a black man. But this one is a black man hating on a black man. And she was telling me that she never thought that one day when she is outside Africa, that she'll meet an African there who hates her. And I was like, yo, it happens. So I decided to went through social media and to see, and I saw, yo, it is true. A lot of stories there that when Africans are in the US, or black Americans, instead of uniting there, you may find them not being in the same page. So I don't know why. Why? Because when you are in someone's land, when you are in someone's land and you find someone from your land, both of you are from, both of you are strangers in that land. I think you need to unite and work together and be friends, talk to each other. Yeah? So she explained me her experience in the elevator. I don't know. It was mad. So that brought me to another discussion, that is being black bad? Like, is being black a crime? Because there is a woman from Kenya, or is it from Nigeria? She was in Kenya, and she was saying that in Kenya you may face in Africa, not in Kenya, in Africa you may face your brothers hating on you because you are too black. Like, they can use your blackness to curse you. Like, maybe you are in an argument, you and your friends, and they will tell you, see how you are black. Even a black brother, you are in the same country, but they be hating, or they be using your blackness to crucify you. If you are too black more than them, or they have somehow brown color and you are too black, they use that blackness to say it's a bad thing on you. So it's giving people from outside, it's giving or maybe it's giving a racist a chance to penetrate. It's giving even the whites a chance to penetrate and to frustrate and to oppress us, because even us ourselves, we don't take care of ourselves. Even us ourselves, we don't love each other. Because, for example, my skin is a little bit, you know, maybe my skin is a little bit brown. And I have my brother has, maybe his skin is totally black, like black. So I'll be seeing that I am more of good than him or her. I see myself, maybe because I'm a little bit brown, that I'm more better than, you know, than him. And that's bad. That's bad. That's bad. That's bad. This is the same things that will make sure that we are still down as Africans. These are the same things that will make sure that Africans will never go somewhere. Because how can you hate on your brother? You are both black. And you are using, because she or he is more black than you. You see, like you know, you are better off. That's bad. I don't know. How was your experience? If you have any experience as a black man in the US or as a black man in Africa, if you have any experience that you met with other black people, like if you have any experience of a black man hating on you, or a black man never talking to you, or your black brother or sister don't talking to you because, you know, you see them talking to white men like, how are you? White man, how are you? They respect, they greet white man, but for you, they just pass by like you don't exist because you are black. I see it's awkward. It is somewhat awkward. It is somewhat awkward. I don't know how we operate, but as black people and black brothers and sisters, we have took ourselves so low, like we see we don't have, you know, we cannot bring anything good out of us, that we cannot even create anything. For example, here in Kenya, we had these stories where you see a kid, maybe a youth, just someone, maybe a small kid or a youth, maybe inventing something, maybe trying to make a Kenyan car, or inventing something, maybe electricity or a vehicle. We had some people, even some youths, inventing aeroplane. Because he is in Kenya, some people from outside, maybe from the US state, they will come, or from China, they will come and pick him. Because we believe that a mind like that does not have to be in Africa. We believe that we don't have, you know, genius people in Africa. That's how we carry ourselves, and which is bad. So in today's video, in this discussion, tell me in the comment section, have you ever met a black brother? You are black and you are meeting a black brother or sister, like she doesn't like you because, you know, we have had these issues that native Africans and black Americans don't like each other. We have these issues, Jamaicans and black Americans, you know, they don't come into good terms, you know. But this, my Kenyan sister, she told me that she just met a black, and mind you that the black person she met was not a black American, was from here, Africa. I don't know, it's from Nigeria, something like that. Nigeria, or from something like that, Nigeria or Rwanda. Like, I didn't believe that. I didn't believe that. And even her herself, she did not believe that, like, wow, I never knew a black person will hate me. It's mad, yo. I don't know. How will we continue? How will we prosper, or how will we build Africa if we don't love each other? We go to the wastelands, or to the western side, because maybe we think it's greener than here. going to, you know, to make money so that we can come and invest in Kenya. But when we are there, when we meet there, we don't want to be on the same page. I don't know why. But I don't want to experience such a thing in my life, like a black brother hating on me. Okay, here in Africa or here in Kenya, you may find like maybe our brothers, we don't come into terms, maybe some issues. But hating me because of my color, I'm too black and you are a little bit brown. And that's why Somalis are saying they're not Africans, because they see they are, you know, they have their color maybe are more brown or white, I don't know, than other Africans. So, what do you think? Tell me on the comment section, what do you think? I don't know if I have someone who have this experience. Tell me the story. Tell me if you have ever met a black person hating on you just because you are too black, you know? Or two black people meeting maybe in the US or in Canada or in whichever country that has white people, and you, instead of, you know, loving your brother, you hate on him, and you are showing more gratitude to the white. I'm not saying that you don't have to show gratitude to the white, but yo, make it equal. If you say hi to the white, say hi to me. Why don't you greet me? Because I'm black too? It's so bad. Tell me in the comment section, what do you think about this video? It was just my friend told me the story, and I say let's share. Let's see. Until next time, don't forget to subscribe. Peace out.